Hello, I'm Pete Gerlach. I'm the author of the nonprofit Break the Cycle website. I want to focus on a topic here today that's of vital interest to you and any children you have and everybody else on the planet. This topic comes from being alive for 73 years and observing the human condition and being a family systems therapist for 31 years. I want to ask you a question to start. On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being high, how effective were your parents? To answer that question, you have to have some criteria. What is an effective parent? I propose, after considering this question for decades, and reading and studying many other people's opinions, there's a lot of confusion and ignorance about how to answer this question. I hope this video will help you make a sensible answer. Let's say that parenting is an intentional activity, usually intentional, of raising a young person to become an independent young adult. A parent may or may not have genetic ties to a child they're caring for. So that's parenting in general. What is effective parenting? I propose that a parent can't tell if she or he is going to be effective until 20-some years have passed and they look at a child who has become an independent, mature, or semi-mature young adult to see if that adult is holistically healthy and is able to become an effective parent themselves if they choose. You can't tell if you're being effective for decades. You have to guess. I would say, from my perspective as a therapist, dealing with personal couple and family problems and observing the news endlessly reporting an incredibly wide range of human problems, the biggest single problem in the United States, I suspect in all other countries also, the biggest single problem, which gets no headlines, no political rhetoric, no commercials, nothing, the biggest single problem is ineffective parenting. How do you feel about that? The reason I say that is ineffective parenting is directly, in my opinion, directly responsible for every single social problem we have. Homelessness, abortion, murder, mental illness, addiction, to name just a few. Every single one of these comes indirectly or directly from the inherited cycle of psychological wounds, which comes from ineffective parenting, and inherited ignorance. Wounds plus ignorance equals ineffective parenting equals all personal, marital, family, social problems. How do you feel about that broad proposal? More to the point, what is an effective parent? I'm going to say something that many attempts to answer this question don't focus on. See what you think. I propose that effective parenting has a number of traits which include these. The first thing effective parents do is teach young dependent children self-respect, self-love, and the desire to care for themselves as opposed to self-neglect. Did your parents do that for you? Teach self-love, self-respect, and self-care. The second thing I think effective parents model and teach is awareness. My experience as a therapist with over 1,000 clients and students is probably fewer than 5% of average women and men of all ages are aware of themselves, their partners, what's going on between them and their partners at the moment, and what's going on around them. Awareness is a learned skill. My parents didn't teach it to me. I'll bet yours parents didn't teach it to you. Nor did their parents teach them. What do you think? That's a second trait of an effective parent, is intentionally teaching children to be aware. Another thing, incidentally, being aware of other people leads to the highly desirable personal trait of empathy. If you're not aware of other people, it's unlikely that you're going to empathize with them, which is going to cause a lot of relationship problems. A major thing that, in my opinion, most parents fail at, because they were never taught, is to teach children effective thinking and communication skills intentionally, patiently, over time. I've been studying these skills for 40 years. There are 7 skills, in my biased opinion, every person on the planet ought to be studying, learning, and practicing. If you can't name these skills, you're not using them, and you're not teaching your kids. Okay? See lesson 2 in my nonprofit website for what the skills are. Also related YouTube videos. Lesson 2 at sfhelp.org. Another thing that effective parents need to teach their children and model for them is healthy 3-level grief. We humans have bonds and losses, broken bonds, all the time throughout our life, far more than just death. Quick example, we lose our youth. We lose hopes and dreams along the way. We lose our health. We lose security temporarily or for a long time. Many people in our culture don't know what is healthy grief. They're not aware of it. They don't pay any attention to it. And many parents don't intentionally instruct their kids and show their kids how to grieve effectively. The downside of that is, if people don't grieve effectively, they're subject to serious, quote, mental illnesses and even physical illnesses, like obesity and depression. So effective parents know about how to grieve effectively and intentionally model and teach their kids how to do that. Did your parents do that for you? Another thing effective parents do is teach kids how to manage guilt. It's a major stressor for many people. There's a way to manage it. Do you know how? See my video. Another thing that people need to know, young children need to learn how, is to manage fear, anxiety, and fear. Did your parents teach you intentionally how to do that? See lesson 1 in my nonprofit educational website for ideas on how to bring fear down to normal and how to teach your kids how to do that. Effective parents teach kids how to learn from their mistakes rather than feel ashamed by them. Effective parents teach their kids ways how to relate to difficult people. Obnoxious, aggressive, controlling, etc. That's a learned skill, how to recognize and deal with difficult people. See my video for practical suggestions. Another thing, in my opinion, effective parents do is teach their children the difference between anger and frustration. How to use each of these normal, primal emotions to better their lives. Not to feel they're negative, not to judge other people badly for them, but to recognize the difference and to use anger and frustration Did your grandparents teach your parents how to do that? Are you teaching your children how to do that? I bet you're not. I suspect you'd agree that effective parents encourage their kids and show them how to learn to love learning. It's a lifelong essential, isn't it? Did your parents do that for you? Did they find a way to make learning fun and interesting and stimulating? I think that's a criteria for effective parenting. A more recent development that our grandparents didn't know about is teaching kids to respect and pay attention to our earth and its dwindling resources. I think that's part of being a modern, effective parent. Are you doing that for your kids? Are there teachers at school? The final one I want to mention, among many others, is effective parents teach their kids and model for them tolerance of other people's cultures, beliefs, religions, and moral behaviors, not immoral behaviors. That seems to be lacking in our world, which is beset by wars. Hasn't happened yet, has it? You can make a difference in your home and your family. Teach tolerance, mutual respect. I've just outlined 11 or 12 criteria that, in my opinion, after decades of wondering about what is an effective parent, I've just outlined a group of criteria. How many parents that you know could name these criteria and describe them? All of them, not just a few, all of them. By the way, notice what I did not include in these criteria. I did not say effective parents teach kids how to operate motor vehicles, how to balance their checkbook, how to make an informed political vote, how to get along with their neighbors, how to maintain their home, how to get regular dental checkups. I didn't say any of those things. I think those are important, yes. I think many parents focus on those good things and they miss the underlying primal criteria that I'm trying to summarize here. What do you think? So now reflect for a moment based on what you just watched and listened to. Would you say your parents, on a scale of 1 to 10, how effective were your parents in giving these criteria to you and modeling them for you? How effective were their parents, your grandparents? How effective a parent, if you have children, if you're responsible for influencing young people, either of your own genetic offspring or someone else's, how effective, according to these criteria, are you? If you have a committed partner who's also raising children with you, how effective is she or he? What would her reaction be to watching this video and discussing it with you? I hope you do that. Overall, I strongly encourage you, if you want to break the toxic wounds and ignorance cycle that is weakening our society and maybe stressing your home, I strongly encourage you to upgrade your knowledge, spend time studying lessons 1 through 6 or 7 at sfhelp.org. No commercials, no ads, no sales pitches, just knowledge based on professional experience over 31 years as a family systems therapist. There's a lot of related videos on YouTube. Two lessons, 1 through 6, and 7 is coming up. I encourage you, for your sake and the sake of any young people that you're influencing, increase your knowledge, increase your effectiveness as a parent. Thanks for watching.